In the last tutorial, we improved the specular lighting. Now, let's take a look at different types of light. There are three main types of light: point, directional, and spotlight. Point lights illuminate the environment in all directions, but the intensity of their light withers as it gets further away. This is the type of light we've used till now, except we didn't incorporate the loss of intensity. So let's quickly do that. First, let's create a vector function named pointLight and copy-paste into it all the things from the main function and make fragColor equal the output of this function. So, the intensity of light has an inverse square relationship to distance in real life, but in computer graphics, we use a somewhat more complicated equation to better control the properties of the light. Instead of having 1 over distance squared, we have 1 over a quadratic equation with respect to distance. This quadratic equation has two constants, a, the quadratic term, and b, the linear term. We can modify these to change how fast the intensity dies out and how far the light reaches. There is no general perfect number for these constants, you just have to play with them and see what works for your scene. Just know that usually the numbers are smaller than 1 if you want your light to reach somewhat far. So to implement this, we first need a distance to the light. The distance is simply the length of the vector that comes from subtracting current position from light position. Since we already use this in our diffuse lighting, I'll create a variable named light vector so that we don't have to calculate it twice. Now we can get the distance by simply using the length function. Lastly, we just write out the equation with the variables and apply it to the specular and diffuse lighting. Here are some examples of the results I got using different constants. The second type of light is the directional light. This is usually considered to be so distant from your scene that the light rays it emits are essentially parallel to one another, just like the rays of the sun. This has no dimming and is actually the easiest of the three to implement. We just need to copy-paste part of the code from the point light, and instead of calculating the light direction based on some positions, we simply give it a constant light direction as a normalized vector 3. Just note that it should point in the opposite direction you want it to affect due to the way I wrote the code here. So if you want the light to come from above, it should point up, not down. And if you press run, you'll see everything is lit up as it should be. The last type of light is the spotlight. The spotlight only lights a conic area, just like a flashlight or a disk lamp. For this, we'll copy-paste the point light code again and begin by adding two floats which will represent the cosine values of two angles. The first angle is the angle between the inner cone and the direction of the light, and the second angle is the angle between the outer cone and the direction of the light. We make use of these two cones in order to have a nice gradient between darkness and light areas, since if we only made the use of one cone, we would just have a direct cutoff from light to darkness. I wrote a cosine value directly in order to save computational power. Do not write the inner and outer cones in terms of angles, since that will require extra calculations and it will slow down the program. Now we need to calculate the angle between the current part that is being lit and the central direction of the light using a dot product. This will give us a cosine value which is perfect to compare with our own cosine values. The last step is to get the intensity at the current spot, which is done using this formula. Make sure to also clamp it between 0 and 1 so you don't get weird values. And lastly, just multiply the diffuse and the specular lighting by the intensity variable. Start the program and you'll see that the light is restricted to one area. Don't forget to write comments for everything you've written to make sure you understand it, and as always, the source code is in the description. Bye!